In a previous video, we tried to create an idealized NES sound chip by altering how it generates sound waves. We tried to have each channel mix linearly, so that the volume of a channel will not be affected by the volume of another channel. This was important because the triangle and noise channels are often affected whenever a sample is playing on the DPCM channel. Besides this, however, we also made it so that the triangle wave generates a smooth waveform without steps, much like how the Commodore C64 sound chip generates it. This is because the triangle waves that the NES generates has stair steps. This affects the sound of the waveform, such that a high-pitched buzzing sound can be heard, especially when the channel is playing a low-pitched note. While we were successful in making the waveform smooth, and many people were happy about the change, there were also a considerable amount of people who did not appreciate the change. Removing the stair steps also removed the high-pitched whine that accompanies the normal sound. This noticeably made the triangle wave harder to hear, especially when it is making low-pitched sounds. This totally makes sense and is a very valid complaint. The human ear is less sensitive to low-frequency or low-pitched sounds. When it comes to the NES, the high-pitched buzzing actually helps. I am trying to keep this simple so I cannot explain the science behind this, but this high-pitched buzzing is actually a harmonic of the bass frequency, and this harmonic tone guides our ears to hear the bass frequency better. Unfortunately, without the harmonics, hearing the bass frequency will be harder, which makes the sound of the triangle wave harder to hear. While I still prefer the original sound of the real hardware, I am also very interested on how an idealized NES sound chip would sound like, and to continue the experimentation, I decided to do one more fix. So, how do we fix this problem without putting the stair steps back? The naive idea would be to simply just amplify the waveform, or, in simple terms, make the triangle wave channel louder. This would help us hear the bass notes easier. However, remember how I said that the human ear is less sensitive to low bass frequencies? This means that our ears actually hear non-bass notes really well, and simply making the triangle channel louder will increase the volume of all notes. This means that while we may be able to hear bass notes easier, the high notes played on the triangle wave channel would get louder than normal, which would quickly get annoying. This is Fear of Dark's Rain Dance, played on a normal NES sound chip and then played again on our previous modified NES sound chip emulator but with a triangle wave amplified. We can hear that while the bass line is easier to hear, the solo melody is much louder than it needs to be as a side effect. Well, how about letting composers just use higher volumes on bass notes while using lesser volume when they want the triangle wave channel to do an awesome solo melody? That also won't work, since we all know that the NES triangle wave channel's volume control cannot be changed. It literally has no volume knob. What we can do is use the ISO 226-2003 standard as reference. This research shows a graph of the sensitivity of our ears to various frequencies. For example, here, we can see that an A4 note at 400 Hz, played at 100 decibels, is roughly the same loudness as a B0 note at 31.5 Hz, played at 120 decibels. Using this graph to adjust the volume of low frequency notes higher lets us hear the lower notes with the same loudness as any other note. Using this technique, we can now listen again to the previous song, this time with a triangle wave channel calibrated to the human ear. This lets us hear the bass notes louder while preserving the normal loudness of the triangle wave channel when it is playing high notes. Granted, this is still not something that will please everybody. Besides the fact that me modifying an emulator to create an idealized NES sound chip is blasphemy to some, making low frequency triangle waves louder will not let you hear the triangle wave if you are listening via a speaker that can't generate low frequency sounds in the first place. This includes many laptop speakers, phone speakers, and maybe even some low quality earphones. A good headphone, some nice loudspeakers, and maybe even attentiveness will be required to actually hear the bass notes. Still, if you do have the proper equipment to enjoy music, you'll probably hear the triangle wave. As per tradition, let's listen to Fear of Dark's Rain Dance to end this video. It uses the triangle wave extensively to play bass lines and even lead melodies, and will be a great example on how we further improve the triangle wave channel. Please notice the triangle wave's volume and see how it changes based on the frequency of the sound it is currently playing. Before I let you go, I would like to thank you for watching this video and also to all of my watchers. I did not say subscribers because even if you're not subscribed, but you share the enthusiasm about experimenting with old hardware and stuff, then I am thankful for having you here. It was totally unexpected, to be honest. I uploaded the first installment to this NES sound chip improvement series with the expectation that it will get 500 views in half a year and die a natural death. But I guess that it had the right combination of thumbnail, title, controversy, and curiosity that it gained lots of views. Whether you liked it or not, I would like to thank everyone for your support. Again, here's Fear of Dark with Rain Dance.